Hello friends, how are you? This video is the second part of the chapter, A Letter to God. Now, let's continue with the chapter. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons, a plague of locusts would be left more than this. So, when the hailstorm was there, and the storm was there, rainfall was there, at that time he was standing in the middle of the field. And his sons were also working in the field. And he told to his sons that instead of this hailstorm, if the insects would have been there, then they must have destroyed the crops less as the crops are destroyed by the hailstorm. The hail has left nothing. This year we will have no corn. Now, whatever crops we were having till now, all the crops are destroyed by this hailstorm because it continued for a long period of time. So, this year we will not be able to grow any corn. That night was a sorrowful one. Sorrowful means he was very sad because all his crops were destroyed. All our work for nothing. There is no one who can help us. We will all go hungry this year. So he was thinking that now financially also I am going to suffer too much and nobody is there in my family, nor I do have any friend who can help me or who can provide me financial help. So this year my family as well as myself are going to suffer a lot. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope, help from God. Now this farmer was living in the middle of the valley and the house, his house was situated in a lonely area. Solitary means lonely. There was no other house around nearby. So in such a situation, the only hope which he had was help from the God. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one dies of hunger. So he was saying to himself that if nobody in this world is ready to help anyone, then certainly, surely God helps that person who is in problem. And because God does not want any of his human being, any of his creation to suffer in life. That's what they say, no one dies of hunger. Because of hunger, not a single person on this earth dies. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. So, for the whole night, he kept on thinking of the God, and he thought that it is only the God who can help me because God knows everything. He is omnipresent, omniscient. Means he is present everywhere. He can see the problems of each and every of his creation. And he can also know the thoughts or the feelings of each and every person, even if those feelings are not expressed. Lencho was an ox of a man working like an animal in the fields, but still he knew how to ride. Now he was a layman. He was a farmer. He was not educated, but still he knew how to write the letters. The following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place it in the mail. Now the next Sunday, which was going to come, so on the next Sunday, during the afternoon time, he started writing a letter because he knew how to write. So he wrote a letter and he decided that I will post this letter through mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. Now he has written a letter not to his friend, not to any of his relative, but to the God. And he has written the address also. God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. So in the letter, what he has written, he told to God that if your help will not come to me, then I will also be hungry and my family will also be hungry. We both will not be able to survive. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes because the hailstorm. So what was his request in the letter? That I require 100 pesos. With that amount, I will grow my crops again. because the hailstorm has destroyed my entire field, my entire crop of corn. So again I have to grow the corn, and for that I require 100 pesos. He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled went to town. Now on the envelope address, what address he has written? He has written to God. It means it was clear that this letter was written to the God, and he was very upset from inside, and with that feeling of disturbance he went to the town. At the post office he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. Now what he did when he reached to the post office, he put a stamp on the envelope and then he put the letter in the mailbox. One of the employees who was a postman and also helped at the post office went to his boss laughing heartily and showed him the letter to God. Now when he had posted the letter in the mailbox, the one of the worker who was working in the post office, he opened the mailbox and he saw that this special letter was written to God. So he started laughing that how foolish the man is that he is writing a letter to the God. Never in his career as a postman had he known that address. Now for the first time in his life, he saw or he has observed a person who was writing a letter to the God, and on the envelope it was mentioned to God. The postmaster, a fat, amiable means friendly and pleasant fellow, also broke out laughing, but almost immediately he turned serious and tapping the letter on his desk announced, "What faith! I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter." So the employee took that letter, special letter which was written to the God. He took that letter to the postmaster, and the postmaster was also very surprised to see that somebody has written a letter to God. So he started thinking that I should help this man. Earlier he started laughing, but later on he realized the seriousness of the letter. He understood the feelings, the unshakable faith, the unshakable belief, the trust of that person in the God. So he thought that I should help this man so that the trust of the trust that the man has in the God does not break. Starting up a correspondence with God, he is a man who is so much trustworthy to God that he has even started the correspondence or conversation with the God. So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea. Answer the letter. Now he has read the letter. In the letter it was written that to the God, the writer has made the request that I want 100 pesos so that I can grow my crop again. So after reading this letter, the postmaster thought that I should give the reply of this letter so that the faith does not break. But when he opened it, it was evident that to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. So he thought earlier, before opening the letter, he thought that I can give the reply of this letter by using a paper and ink or pen. But when he opened the letter, he realized that in order to give the reply of this letter, pen and paper is not needed. But he stuck to his resolution. He asked for money from his employees. He himself gave part of his salary, and several friends of his were obliged to give something for an act of charity. Now charity means donation. The writer has asked from the God for about 100 pesos. So the postmaster was thinking that how can I arrange 100 pesos? It was a large sum of money. So what he did, he asked his employees also to contribute. Then he also himself contributed from his salary, and the other people also were ready to give their contribution as a charity. It was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos, so he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. Now half amount of 100 pesos will be 50 pesos, but somehow he tried to gather about more than half of the amount. And how he has gathered, how he has collected? from his friends, from his relatives, from his employees, and even he himself has contributed. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lencho and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature call. Now, after collecting 70 pesos, he put that much of amount in the envelope and at the top, he has signed with the name of God so that the man could understand that this letter as a reply has come from the God. The following Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. Now, whole week he was very upset, he was disturbed, he was curious also to know that what reply will come from the God. So, the next Sunday, following Sunday, he again came to the post office. But today he came quite early because he was expecting some response from the God. It was the postman himself who handed the letter to him, while the postmaster experiences the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed looked on from his office. Now, the letter on which the sign of the God was there, that letter was given by the postman to the writer, and the postmaster was separately sitting in his office watching the expression of the man of the writer, that how he would react when he will get this letter back as a response from the God. Lencho showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money. Such was his confidence, but he became angry when he counted the money. So Lencho was not at all surprised on looking at the money, but he was, because he had expected that some other response God is going to give. Such was his confidence. So he was not surprised to see the reply from the God. This shows that he had an unshakable trust and belief in God. But he became angry when he counted the money. So he opened the letter and he started counting the money. He thought that this money, this 70 pesos, has been sent by the God. So he started counting the money. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lencho what he had requested. He had so much trust in God that he thought that if I have asked 100 pesos from God, God will surely give him. Total whole amount he will give him, that is 100 pesos. And when he will send the money, he will not make any mistake because he is a God. Immediately, Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write with much wrinkling of his brow. Wrinkling of his brow means he was very angry, caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. Suddenly, he went to the counter and he asked the postman to give him the paper and pen. And after taking the paper and pen, he started writing the letter. And in the letter, he had expressed his anger. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp, which he licked and then affixed to the envelope with a blow of his fist. Now, after writing the letter, he put the letter in the envelope and he took the stamp also and he pasted the stamp on the envelope. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. Now, as soon as the writer has put the letter into the mailbox and went away, immediately postmaster came there and opened the mailbox because he was very curious to know that what he has written in the letter after seeing the amount which he got from God. It said, God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Send me the rest since I need it very much. But don't send it to me through the mail because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks, Lencho. So what he has written in the letter? He has written to the God that I know that if I have asked you for 100 pesos, you suddenly would have sent me 100 pesos. But since you have sent this letter through mail, so the employees who are working in this post office, they have taken away my amount, that is 30 pesos, and left only 70 pesos in this envelope. So he has written, he has requested to the God that next time when you will send me back 30 pesos, the remaining amount, then don't send it through the mail, because the people who are working in this post office, they are corrupt, they are not honest. Again, they will take away my money. So the irony is that he did not know that these employees only, they have contributed from their salary and helped Lencho. On the other hand, he started blaming these employees. He told them corrupt, he told them liars, and he requested the God that don't send the money through the mail or through mailbox. So this shows that he was unaware of the genuine help made by the employees of the post office to the Lencho. Instead of that, he started blaming them. So I hope the chapter is clear to you. In the next video, we will discuss the question answers of the chapter. Thank you.